All right, good afternoon to everybody. We just join us now. How are you doing this afternoon? I hope, say, your Tuesday, they go on a cool mood. And I hope say you're very happy. Now, welcome to the show where they always give you everything where they happen for inside we Obodo Nigeria and Obodo the world. Now, today, we go there concentrate more on top of the challenges of small business for inside Obodo Nigeria. And we'll get one kajat person who will join us inside the studio to talk about most of these challenges. But I would also still like ask you this question. Wetin be your greatest fear? Wetin be your greatest fear? Now begin to tell us on top of Twitter, make we know Wetin be your greatest fear. And once time reach, we go talk about Wetin be our own greatest fear. Not only me, Betiana stay there, yeah. But what's your greatest fear, Betiana?
The time don't reach.
I just want to know. You give me like a tip.
My greatest fear now failure.
Mm.
Of anything at all. Failure in marriage, failure in my career, failure in anything. Now my greatest fear be that.
Really?
Yes.
Failure?
Yeah.
Wow. So what do they do to actually conquer that fear? Because you know how they talk, say, now when you start to fear things, now then they attract within you the fear.
I don't believe in that one. But then, because say my greatest fear and a failure, I try as much as possible not to put my hand in everything. Now take everything one step at a time. If I do A, I know I do A. And I must make sure, say, I do A to the latter. And I know, say, okay, yes, I don't conquer A. Oh, yeah, over to the next B. Maybe we start them like that. Because if I know, say, if I do A to V, I feel failing one or two. So let's do one at a time and make sure, say, okay, that one where they do at hand, I do them to the latter.
You know, funny enough, eh? I actually like, I like to fail because it puts me, I don't say failure, not just a step ahead. So if I do something today and not actually not work out well for me, I don't say, yes, I need to try again, but try a better way. But for me, basically...
Not in all things.
No, as in for you...
Now, if you talk like that, it means, okay, you like to try marriage, then the first marriage fails.
No, it never happened.
No, yes,
it's
that's...
It never happened.
That your, is not my fear. That your logic, no, apply to everything.
And it doesn't apply to everything anyway in life. Like marriage, God forbid, I would never divorce. But everything where I don't put my hand in... Everything, if I fail, I know they always just draw back and say, oh, it's my greatest fear.
Well, of course, you go buckle up and do them again. Buckle up.
But my own greatest fear, and I try to conquer them because it's annoying, not death.
Oh, no, that will not be any fear for me at all.
I don't know why.
Maybe because...
Like, even the thought of myself...
Are you serious?
I never thought of this one before, right? But
no.
I'm serious.
But now, I don't fear death in any way. Maybe because I don't lose so many people where they did very death. Man. It don't become part of life to me. Say, okay, one day, everybody must go.
You never understand. My own not be the one. Yes, it's, I know say everybody must go.
If you come today,
but I'm thinking
fine.
Of, okay, so what's going to happen tomorrow? Okay, so if person go now, so nobody going to know about this person again. So where am I going to?
I'm going to heaven.
So okay, so what will I be doing?
I'm going to be dining with the Lord.
I think basically the fear of the unknown is my major problem.
No.
Yeah, when it comes to that. But you were there, the waiting be your greatest fear. We don't talk our own. Betiana don't talk say failure. Me don't talk say death. But what's your greatest fear? Follow us on top Twitter. We there, Talk Wazobia. On top Facebook, Talk Wazobia TV. Now, when we come back after the break, we'll get one kajad woman where they do better things for inside Obodo Nigeria. And she will surely tell us our greatest fear. They come back. Welcome back. Now, I tell you, say we go get one kajad guest where you go join us inside the studio. But I beg, this kajad guest now, English, now she did speak. But she go try put small pigeon inside them, you understand? All right, Betiana, just tell us what we get inside the studio.
Okay, yes, we get very kajad person where she don't change the face of Akamu, aka Ogi, for inside the Obodo Ninja. Then they call her Nwanyiakamu, others they call her Iya Ologi. We have the CEO of Bubez Foods in the building. Welcome, ma.
Thank you, Betty.
Yeah.
She didn't see that coming.
I'll tell you.
Iyalogi. Iyalogi, one of Africa.
Mama of
Ogi.
Yes, Pap.
Mama of Pap.
Then for the Igbo version, 1 year, Akamu. 1 year.
Good to have you inside the studio.
Thank you. Now, before
you actually come in, we'll talk about our greatest fear. And Betiana talks say our greatest fear na failure, mine na death. Wetin be your greatest fear?
My greatest fear na sickness.
Oh, really?
Because for some...
Speak the English.
So, because I think say... Oh, no.
Don't worry,
just speak the English, no worry.
Say. Yeah, because for some reason, I think it's out of control. Okay. But for every other thing, I think there's always a way out. But when the sickness come, you don't come. You know, what can you really do?
So you feel sickness out of control?
A lot of it.
Really?
The ones that will now get to death that you're scared of. So when you hear things like cancer, things like, what have people really done, you know, to attract cancer? There's no answer.
True, because they never really find the root cause of any type of cancer at all.
Yeah.
Unlike HIV, where we know, say, okay, if you do some kind of bad things or if you use needle or that or this.
So, but, and even things like the HIV now, say, get cure or, you know, so the fact that
if you manage
it, if you manage it,
but you know, some other ones, it's like you don't come. Somehow, you know. So, in all honesty, that's my greatest fear.
Now, still talking about sickness. Now, what do you think about even though a lot of people actually go with people going online to solicit for help in terms of when they're sick and whatever, because we see the story of the recent one we actually happened. We don't want to really talk too much about it. And at the end of the day, they talk saying a fraud or not be fraud, police can't they involve. What do you think about those where they actually go online to solicit for help? You support that or?
No. Nobody say I support or I don't support.
Okay.
Because my philosophy in life is, person where they advise you, is advising you from a past, present, and where the person is going to. So, not be about support or no support. Hey, if you need help and you feel, say now the way where you go fit get the help, then that's fine. So it's neither here nor there whether it good or it bad or it no good. So if I say my fear and a sickness, and okay, so for instance, let's use sickness where you feel cure and now money, and I don't have the money, and I know say if I reach out to people they'll bail me out. Why not? I reach out to you to bail me out, but I think the problem here is the integrity part of it. So it's about, is it true or is it not true? That's really the problem, but not really about whether I come online, come ask you for money, you know, which is what I say, that part of the problem we get for Nigeria is that people have formed strata in their head where they believe that, okay, so I know if you beg, or so as they sell Akamu now, I know if you sell Akamu. Then you go there, they die. Meanwhile, you know, say if you sell the account, money go come and, you know, and you can do one or two things. So it's a mindset thing as opposed to, is it right or is it wrong?
Yeah, I actually like that in particular response. Now let's talk about Akamu.